गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12. वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर क्लास विथ रेफ्यूजी प्रॉब्लम. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड आवर टॉपिक्स, द रिवर वाटर डिस्प्यूट एंड द प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू इट, प्लस हाउ इट वॉज रिजॉल्व्ड. दीज ऑल टॉपिक्स वी हैव डन. देन वी हैव डन द फाउंडेशन ऑफ द इंडियन डेमोक्रेसी, दैट टॉपिक्स, ऑल द डिटेल एनालिसिस वी हैव डन, द फर्स्ट जनरल इलेक्शंस रिलेटेड टू हु वॉज द फर्स्ट प्राइम मिनिस्टर and what was the result and impact of the first general election, detailed analysis related to first general elections, related to with its starting and till the impact. So this is the last topic of your lesson, as the linguistic organization of the states topic is deleted in your current IAC syllabus, which has been given by the council, the revised syllabus now. So linguistic organization is deleted, hence so the last topic, the formation of Indian democracy, that topic, till that the lesson is over. So worksheet was also given to you. I hope you all have solved it. But then also I am today giving in today's class also the answers of the worksheet. I have given in your written format. I am discussing also certain questions which you should follow. It's important also, which you should understand. Like what is mean by refugee problem, which is a very vital important topic to understand after the partition of India, because this was the very important conditions which India was facing in that situation of partition phase, as the all the troubles and turmoils what was going on in that time was mainly related to the rehabilitation of the refugees. So what was a refugee problem? Let us discuss again. 1947, India became independent, and thus now the Indian people should rule the country with their elected representatives. And hastily it was created as a great problem, mainly the communal problem. Lakhs of refugees were forced to leave their ancestral houses and entered into two new states. Those were India and Pakistan. So these two new states faced the biggest problem, which was the refugee problem, the resettlement of the refugees of India. So this was known as the refugee problem. Next, we are also facing the from which parts of the country the refugees came to India. So we have already discussed from which parts the refugees came in India. Those were the incoming of refugees from West Punjab, which is now in Pakistan, to East Punjab, the refugees from Northwest Frontier Province, refugees from province of Sindh, and refugees from East Bengal to West Bengal. So these part refugees migration was done. From which part the refugees came? So what was the function of the Director General for the rehabilitation of these refugees now? This was the question after this I had given, related question only, related to the refugees who came from different parts of country. They came from Northwest Frontier Province, Sindh, East Bengal, West Bengal. These all migrations was done. So now how they were settled, how their rehabilitation was done by the Director General? What was the main function of him? So Director General of Rehabilitation was mainly appointed for the distribution of land, providing shelters and jobs for those huge displaced persons, as the central government spent about 22 million from 1947 to 1969 for the resettlement of those displaced persons. Gradually, the peasants and the farmers from West Punjab were fairly rehabilitated in a reasonable span of time. A time period was taken, but then also their settlement was done and given to them. The Punjab government, with cooperation of the central government, planned some industrial towns also, like Faridabad, Nilokheri in Kurukshetra and Rajpura form them. So government was taking certain measures for the rehabilitation of these people, even for peasants and farmers some loans and rehabilitation funds were also provided at that time. Next, I asked you the question was, refugees of which part were encamped along the Delhi-Mathura main road? So people from northwest frontier province lived in the camp along Delhi-Mathura main road, and there only nearby 16 miles south of Delhi, government also planned for preparing and constructing a township for the rehabilitation of this number of huge refugees who migrated from this province, northwest frontier province. Refugees of which areas crossed over to Bombay and Rajasthan? Mainly Hindus of Sindh, we all know. They came to Bombay and then they also came to Rajasthan. Refugees of which areas were very worse sufferers? The refugees who actually Hindu refugees from East Bengal which came were the worst sufferers. They faced the biggest problem because in West Bengal already the population pressure was much, and in fact the East Bengal also the people were migrating. The influx of refugees were too much, and the output of refugees, when refugees who were going out to the East Bengal region compared to coming, the entering of the refugees, it was very 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 less. The refugees who were going out was very less and compared to the refugees who was coming. So giving them shelter, giving them job opportunities was a big task for the government, a very big challenge to take, to handle, to control. I hope you all are having copies and pen in your hand. You are noting down whatever I am speaking. Then also you are getting in the note form also the answers which I am discussing with you today. Which state of India was distributed most and affected, disturbed and affected most by the influx of refugees? It was West Bengal, very well, because the East Bengal people were maximum shifting to West Bengal region, and the problem they faced was the resettlement of their properties. This was the biggest problem. Social economic pressure, political pressure, population pressure was the main problem the people at that time in West Bengal were facing. The next question I had given to you, what was Indus River water dispute? In Indus River water dispute, what do you understand by this term? What is this river water dispute? As after partition, India got only 5 million out of 28 million acre of lands irrigated by Indus and its tributaries like Ravi, Bias and Satluj. What was the problem? Main problem was the waters of western rivers went into the sea. So the Pakistan canals were solely dependent on the eastern rivers flowing through East Punjab. Whereas India also wanted to utilize the waters of eastern rivers, namely Ravi, Bias, Satluj, for agriculture development. Now thus the division of the flow of water was very well required from these places, so that both of the states require the full support for its irrigational facilities to the agricultural field. Hence this issue between these two new born states for any natural calamity like a flood or drought in Pakistan, India was mainly blamed, responsible because of these reasons, which they were facing. The water dispute between India and Pakistan was settled through intervention of Eugene Black and the president of the World Bank. Thus, as a result, the Indus water dispute was formed due to the due to the problem created between India and Pakistan over the partition of the river, that is Ravi, Bias and Satluj, and plus the use of the water for agricultural purposes, Ravi, Bias and Satluj rivers. Next is, who was Eugene Black? Eugene Black was the president of World Bank. He was the main person for the settlement of these two new states born over the river water dispute by building up the canal project, where the division of the water, division ratio of the river areas were divided. Which countries agreed to contribute to the Indus Basin Development Fund? Those were Austria, Canada, Germany, Britain, New Zealand and America who agreed to pay for generously for this project. Why were the Indian people unhappy over this decision? Because people did not want to share the river waters. Though the project of canal which was passed, it forced so. Who and when went to Karachi to sign the Indus Water Treaty? Jawaharlal Nehru in 19 September 1960. Now next I asked you, why did lakhs of refugees leave their ancestral homes? What was the reason for the refugees to leave their home after the partition? Why it was required so? As India faced a number of problems related to migration of refugees, it became independent. After the partition, India faced the biggest problem, which was communal problem, which forced lakhs of people, refugees, to leave their own home, the own land, and enter into a new state, India and Pakistan. Thus, in 1947, Bengal was partitioned into the Indian state of West Bengal and Pakistan province of East Bengal. Hence the partition of Bengal and Punjab, which was the part of independence of India, left people to migrate and leave their ancestral homeland. The unfavorable condition to stay after the partition also forced the refugees to migrate, as riots and community breakups lead the people to move from their homeland after partition. How did the refugees of Sindh reach to Bombay and Rajasthan? That is the biggest question. Refugees of Sindh, some by through water bodies, through by boats, they reached to Bombay, and from there by land route they reached to Rajasthan. Discuss how West Bengal was affected by the influx of refugees. How West Bengal was affected by the influx of refugees? Mainly Hindu refugees from East Bengal were the worst sufferers. Nearly 1 million refugees had crossed over from East Bengal to West Bengal, and thus the exodus of Hindus from East to West Bengal was massive. In contrast to West Bengal, the exodus of Hindus from East to West was massive. By contrast, the number of Muslims who left West Bengal to East Bengal after the partition, this was the biggest problem faced in West Bengal. Who was the first Prime Minister of India? Jawaharlal Nehru after the partition, and first general election was taken place in 1951 to 52. The first Chief Election Commissioner to organize the election in India was Sukumar Sen. And for in the next class, I have given you some more questions to solve in the worksheet. Please go through it, try to solve it. If you are not getting the answers in the next worksheet, I am going to give you. So now we are going to start a new lesson, as we have already completed refugee problem and discussion of some related questions important related to this lesson. Some short, some brief, and some long also, in detail analysis also. So follow those questions also and read the lesson, the refugee problem chapter. And now we are going to come to the next lesson, that is chapter 3, that is challenges to the Indian democracy. Now how the challenges were faced and given to the Indian democracy, our Indian democracy, towards the end of Nehru's life. K. Kamraj became the president of All India Congress Committee. After Nehru's death, Kamraj was instrumental to bring Lal Bahadur Shastri to power. This was the main challenge going on with the authority, to bring the power and position to Lal Bahadur Shastri in 1964. But he was as the part of the group of leaders in Congress known as the syndicate. After Lal Bahadur Shastri's sudden death in Soviet Russia, the syndicate favored Nehru's daughter, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, over the veteran politician Morarji Desai. At the initiative of Kamraj, Mrs. Indira Gandhi became the Prime Minister of India in 1967. So, Mrs. Indira Gandhi became the Prime Minister of India in 1967, The first serious challenge given to the Congress, which came in 1967, when some Mukta Vidhayak Dal won the control over several states. Why we are going through this topic is, we are going entering into the split in the Congress phase. How within the Congress only split had occurred, how it factions have been formed, how there were certain divisions done in the Congress body only. There was first serious challenge which was faced during the Congress 1967 when Samyukta Vidhayak Dal won control over several states in Hindi belt. Mrs. Indira Gandhi was then challenged by majority party leadership. Under the conflict, the split of the Congress was done as Congress R and Congress O. The split of the Congress was the result of the growing difference between the syndicate or the old guards and Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Mrs. Indira Gandhi quickly took control of the finance from Morarji Desai and passed the Bank Nationalization Ordinance. Thus, after death of President Zakir Hussain, the syndicate factions chose Sanjiva Reddy as the Congress candidate. Hence, in this way, the split in the Congress was held and the situation was controlled somehow by Mrs. Indira Gandhi. But it is also told that the split in some ways has been seen as a left-wing and right-wing conflict. Mrs. Gandhi wanted to follow a popular agenda. To gather support, she then raised the slogans such as Garibi Hatao, remove poverty, and wanted to develop closer ties with Soviet Russia. But the old guards of Indian National Congress O stood for a more conservative agenda and disrupted the Soviet help. Thus, in this position, in this situation, as the Indian National Congress O stood for a more conservative agenda and destructive to Soviet help, there came the emergence of new political parties with main leaders. One important feature of the election of 1967 was coming together of the opposition parties. Some of them formed anti-Congress fronts also in some states. In other cases, they entered into a series of electoral adjustments. Hence, those parties were not favoring the ideas, the procedures, the plans done under Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Thus, Janasangh emerged as the main opposition party in UP, Madhya Pradesh, Haryana, Swatantra Party in Orissa, Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, and SS in Bihar, and Communist Party in West Bengal and Kerala also. So, there were certain factions done in the Congress body. There were certain effect of the anti-Congress parties also formed due to the ideas, the conflicts, the plans which was done under Mrs. Indira Gandhi. There was certain importance of the election of 1967. As in 1967, India held several general elections to 4th Lok Sabha in Indian National Congress. Please underline it. Take out your book and page number 58 and the topic importance of elections of 1967 take out. In that you underline, in 1967 India held general elections to 4th Lok Sabha. Short notes type of question come over this topic. What do you understand by the importance of the elections of 1967? Yeah, what were the importance of the election of 1967? These are the vital questions from these chapters which come. What was the reason for the split in the Congress? The ideas and difference between the two factions, the old syndicate guards and the Mrs. Indira Gandhi's ideas. So in 1967, India held general elections to 4th Lok Sabha. The Indian National Congress remained a power by winning a clear majority of seats. But the party now held 70 less seats. Thus, Indira Gandhi, the daughter of late Jawaharlal Nehru, had succeeded Lal Bahadur Shastri as the leader. Very soon, a rift emerged between her and the Deputy Prime Minister, Morarji Desai, who had been her rival from 1966 party leadership contest. Yes, from very well, she was the first challenge of Morarji Desai. We already know this thing, that she was given the first seat, she was the first challenge for Morarji Desai. One important feature of 1967 election was coming together of the opposition parties, which was a very important part in this election. Some of them formed anti-Congress fronts in some states. In other cases, they entered into series of electoral adjustments. Another important feature of election of 1967 was dramatic defeat of Congress. Though Congress succeeded in retaining control of Lok Sabha, but its majority was drastically reduced in the Congress. Thus, they lost its majority and control of Lok Sabha, which reduced with a drastic fall. Congress also lost in assemblies. These were in Bihar, UP, Rajasthan, Punjab, West Bengal, Orissa. Thus, this was the effect of the anti-Congress parties who had become so popular and powerful to revenge and to challenge the bodies formed under the Congress. Thus, now we will understand result and impact. The results of the elections of 1967, as given in your textbook also, it says that Congress party lost confidence of the people. People started not to support the Congress party. The party suffered a serious setback from the part of elections, from the part of voting pattern, from the part of people's support. Though it succeeded in retaining power, the decline of the support for Congress was seen very clearly. Thus, the electoral losses of the party led Mrs. Indira Gandhi becoming assertive. She started to force the laws brought down by her. She started to give people the laws which were made, the plans which was made, to forcefully accept and abide by her rules and regulation. Though it was correct or incorrect, the people had to follow it. So she started somehow to adopt certain assertive measures, it is told, and opting for a series of choices. This put her against the rest of the party establishment. Now people started to stand against her. The internal strife started now, continued to worsen the relations between the members of the Congress party. It worsened until she was expelled from the party in November 1969. And this action led to the split of the party into two factions. The Congress O, which we read in the beginning of the lesson, the Congress O led by Morarji Desai, and Congress R led by Indira Gandhi. The ideas, the plans which were through assertive methods given down by Indira Gandhi, in this way she was sided up, she was divided with her own body of Congress R. Now she continued to head a minority government with support from the CPI until she called an early elections in 1971. So till 1971 we are reading that there is split in the Congress, which was done with Congress O led by Morarji Desai, and the split in the party led with Congress R formation under Indira Gandhi. Next topic, till this much you have to study from the lesson as according to syllabus. Beyond this they are not going, they are giving you the limits up to the formation of the split of the Congress and results of the election. First, importance of the election of 1967, what result it gave, why it was held, what was the importance, what was the reason, and then what were the result. The result gave what? The split in the Congress, the Congress O and Congress R. The split in the party, that was the main, and plus giving power to the new parties, anti-Congress parties, which was formed after the importance, after the elections held of the 1967. Next is Naxal movement, next topic in this lesson, which you have to study according to your present revised syllabus of ISC. The term Naxalite comes from the word Naxalbari, a small village in West Bengal. There were a section of Communist Party of India Marxists led by Kanu Sanyal and Jangal Santhal initiated a violent uprising in 1967. On 18th May, in Siliguri, Kisan Sabha declared support for the movement to adopt armed struggle to redistribute land to the landless farmers, laborers. There were certain causes for the rise of this Naxalite movement in India. It is a guerrilla insurgency led by the group of left radical communists. Why the main reason starts the root for the starting of the Naxal movement in India is very ancient, and it is related to the troubles, the tortures which was done to the peasants and the farmers and the tribal people in the forest areas, for whom these people started to stand, started to fight against the government authority. Now let us study in detail that what were the causes which led them to fight against the government authority. At first, the root of the conflict can be traced in the failure of the Indian government to implement provisions of the 5th and the 9th schedules of Indian Constitution. What were those 5th schedules? In 5th schedule, the rules, the acts in the constitution which was formed stated that all the forest reserved and lands that are inhabited, underline it. Very important in this, main causes for the rise of the Naxal movement. The 5th schedule, it states that all forest reserves and lands that are inhabited by the scheduled tribes are not to be administered by the tribal advisory council independent of state government. No Indian state had implemented the tribal advisory councils. On the other hand, legislation had been passed enabling the pharmaceutical companies. Pharmaceutical companies are also establishing their factories here, and here certain lands are also given from those areas. So where the people will go? Here people are claiming for their lands, and here these people are claiming for establishment of the companies. Hence means this shows that proper distribution of the land was not given by the government, not issued by the government in a proper order. So now the 9th schedule also faces some main problems of constitution. Passed a series of land legislation. It was observed that there was a concentration of land among a few rich upper castes. It also imposed that land ceiling laws which limit the amount of the land which a single person can hold. This excess lands were to be requisitioned and redistributed by the government among the peasants. But these provisions were only written in the constitution. They were not implemented. So now, to protect the constitution's laws, what the government had given to the landless farmers and laborers to protect their right, the failure of the government to implement those provisions enraged these classes of revolt, which was actually started by the Naxal movement, who started to fight for these lands, for these landless farmers and laborers under Charu Majumdar and Kanu Sanyal. So in the next class, I am going to continue with the activities which were actually adopted by Charu Majumdar and Kanu Sanyal to forward to make this movement a success. So in the next class, we'll come with a new topic. For today's class, you study which topics I have told. First is the factions in the Congress, why it was done, one reason. The notes are also given to you. Next, the importance of the election of 1967, the power, the prestige which was regained by the anti-Congress parties, then the new formation of the split of the party with Congress O and Congress R. Then we'll come to the Naxal movement. What do you understand by the term Naxal? And next is the causes of its rise, the main rise of the Naxal movement, the main cause for the rise of the Naxal movement. So this is the main topics which you are going to study. Follow it, read it after the today's class, following the class, and I hope the question answers which I have given as homework, try to solve it. And if you are facing some problem to answer it, in the next class you are going to get the answers related to it. So thank you. In the next class, I will come with a new topic from the same lesson. Certain topics are still left out, which I am going to discuss with you related to this lesson. That is chapter 3, the challenges to the Indian democracy. So this part we are going to study in the next class. Thank you.